Students, in this video we see implementation of queue using linked list. We have already implemented queue by using array, but now we implement queue here by using linked list. Now, as we know, linked list is like this: first node, then second node. Node's address is inside first node, then this is the third node. This is the general structure of any linked list, or we can say that this is singly linked list. Okay, so if first value is 10, data part is 10, then 20, then 30, 40, and if this is the last node, then as we know, we store here null. Okay, null. Now, if this node address is 1000, suppose this node address is 2000 and this node's address is 3000 and this last node's address is suppose 4000, then what happens? Inside this link part or pointer, there is 2000, okay? 2000 address is there. Here 3000 address means third node's address. So in this way, linked list we implement. We already seen how stack we can implement by using linked list. Now here we implement queue by using linked list. Now as we know, queue is the first in first out. Okay, FIFO, first in and first out means the element inserted first inside queue, that same element deleted first, okay, will be deleted first. And also we mention the front node as first node as front and last node as rear. Okay, last node is we say rear and front, first node is we say front. Inside stack we adjust the top, and inside queue we need to adjust front and rear node. Okay, so see in this how we can implement a queue. Here we need to develop logic behind insertion and deletion. While we insert new node inside this queue, what we need to do, if this is the previous queue structure or current situation of queue, there is a front node is here and rear node is here. These front and rear are pointer, which is of node type pointer, and inside front there is an address of first node and inside rear there is an address of last node. So these are not the array index here. Now these are the node pointers, and we store node address inside front and rear. So how we can implement insert function on queue by using linked list? Think about it. We need to, as usual, we need to create one node. Okay, here we allocate memory for new node. This is the new node. Okay, we created new node inside stack implementation, so we are familiar now about how to create new node, how to allocate memory dynamically and all. Now we create this new node first. As we know, linked list means we allocate memory dynamically. Whenever user gives the choice as insert, then only we create new node, means allocate the memory for this new node, then adjust the data part, means whatever the element user want to store inside this queue, we store in this data part, new node's data part. Then as we know, queue is the first in first out, so we insert element at the end and delete element from the front. So whatever the new element we insert, we need to insert at rear end. Okay, so we need to adjust the link part in this way, such that this new node is will become the last node, and rare we will adjust as new node. Rare is equal to new node. Means what? This is the separate node now. Just we have created this new node and adjusted the data part. Then this is the next part. Now if this node becomes the last node, if this is the situation, then we need to store null inside this link part. Okay. There is no need to attach this node or there is no any other node present after this node. This is only the last node. So we need to adjust the next part of this new node as null. Then still this node is a separate node from our queue. Then what happens or what we need to do here? This is the rare. Okay. Inside a rare, there is an address of last node. And inside new node, there is address of this current new node. Now what we need to do? We need to attach this new node to our existing queue. So how we can attach? How we can link this new node to previous queue? As we know, we need to attach or we need to add the new element inside queue at the rare end. So here, this is the last element. In current situation, this is the last element. Now our node, our new node will be last element. So this link we need to destroy. Okay, this is not now the last element. So we need to adjust this link. Here we need to store the address of new node. If new node address is suppose 5000, then what we need to do? We need to store this 5000 inside this link part, rare's next part. Current rare is at here. So we need to adjust this link part as this node pointing towards the new node. Okay. So this link we need to adjust, and how we can adjust this link? The next of rare, here our rare is at this point. Next of rare, our previous next of rare is null. Now we store the new node address, means we adjust like this. The next part of rare is equal to new node. Now this node is not separate, and we attach this new node to previous queue. Now only the part is remaining. Now our rare will become this node. Okay, we need to store address of this node inside rare. Inside array implementation, what we do? Rare plus plus, because rare is array index. Now rare is not our array index, and rare is not a type of integer variable. So this type of updation is not we need to do here, rare plus plus, but rare is equal to, okay, this node is now rare. So how we can get this new node? By using new node. Okay, new node is our current node, inserted node. Okay, so this updation, now our rare pointing towards the new node and not the previous rare. In this way we update a rare. Okay, rare is equal to new node. Now inside a rare there is an address 5000, and inside new node there is also 5000. So for this node there are two names, rare and new node. Both are pointing towards the same node. But rare and front are our global variables, and new node is only the temporary variable. For temporary purpose we use this new node. After our work completion, this new node's memory will be deleted or free. Okay, but front and rare are still in memory. So this is the logic behind insertion. Now what happens if a user want to delete some element or delete one element from the queue? Then what is the code here? We generally delete the element from front. Okay, first node we need to delete. Now as usual, first condition is if the queue is empty, then we can't delete any element from the queue. So first we need to check the condition, like if front is exactly equal to null. First time we initialize front and rear as null. Okay, we initialize front and rear is equal to null initially. So if front or rear is exactly equal to null, that means our queue is empty and there is no any single element, so we can't delete. Now else part is what? If there are some elements, there are some elements present inside queue and we need to delete the front element, then what is the logic? This element we need to delete. So first we need to assign this node as temporary. Okay, inside insertion we assign new node, or we use temporary new node. Here we use temporary node. Here we name as temp. Now the address of this node is stored inside a temporary as well as front. Okay, so first node address is at temporary as well as front. Now we create one new node pointer named as temporary, and store temporary is equal to front. Okay, now what we need to do? Front we can update. Okay, now this node address is at temporary pointer also, so we can easily, or we can update front to next node. Okay, front we update like our new front is this, because this node will be deleted. Now the front node becomes this node. Okay, so how we can update this front? This node is this second node's address is stored inside this front, so we can update the front as, not front plus plus because this is not the array implementation, but we need to update the front as front is equal to front next, or next of front. Okay, inside front current address is 1000. Now we need to store 2000, and where is 2000? Inside its next part. Okay, this is the 2000. We need to store 2000 inside front. So we need to do this statement. In this way we update the front. Now what is the situation here? Our front is updated here. Now our this node address is stored inside temporary only and not inside front, because our front is updated here. Now what happened? We take this data part to for returning purpose, to store this temporary data inside n. How we can do this? Data part of temporary is equal to, okay, n is equal to data part of temporary, because this node's address is only in temporary now. So n is equal to data of temporary. Now this link part we need to destroy first. This link part, how we can destroy? The next of temporary, okay, the next part, this is the next part and this is the data part. So next part of temporary is equal to, there is an address of second node 2000, but we need to separate this node. Okay, so we need to store inside next null. So what happened inside memory? There is no any address of second node after executing this line. There is null, means there is no any single address present inside this. Now this temporary node is separated from our existing queue. Okay, now we can easily delete this node. How we can delete this node? By using free function. Memory will be deleted after executing this code. So this is the logic behind delete, and we already discussed the logic behind it.